I'm going to teach you how to make $10,000 a month online as a digital artist. Well, you guys asked for it, so here it is. Hi, my name's Thomas, and I've made a decent career out of selling helpful digital products online through various different companies and platforms that I've created over the years. Some of these products have been flops, while others have been life-changing successes. And in this three-part series, I'm going to share what I know with you to help try and change your life and create sustainable and substantial passive income completely online using your digital art skills. I'm not talking about making a bit of side money. I'm talking about a life-changing amount of money and changing your life for the better. Most artists have it pretty hard out there, so I really hope this helps some people. And if you already have a course or a product that's struggling, this guide should help you identify its issues and how to correct them. Now, I'm not really here to pitch anything to you. I'm not trying to get you to sign up to a mailing list. I just generally want to help artists realize their true potential. And I think now is the perfect time to start setting yourself up for the future. I'm also giving away $500 to a random person who subscribes to my YouTube channel over the next 5 days. So make sure to hit that subscribe button and you could be $500 richer by the end of the week. I'm not joking. I'm actually giving away $500 to a random subscriber. This series is going to be broken up into three parts, where part number one is going to cover building your product, which is this episode. The next one will be building your audience, where I'm going to share with you how I grow on social media and other platforms to help you get your idea out there. The third and final part is going to be building your income, where I'm going to talk about building trust with your audience and actually locking down sales. This series is focused on passive money making with a digital product. I'm not just here to say, oh, well, upload your 3D models to Sketchfab or create a profile on Fiverr, sell your art prints. This is going to be focused on how I found results based on my own success and failures. Now, I'm not trying to say that if you follow this video to the T, you're going to become some sort of overnight millionaire. No. The reality of it is, there's no secret formula to making money online. The majority of your success is going to come from within yourself and learning from your mistakes and improving upon them. Don't get sucked in by these money-making gurus who are just trying to sell you $1,000 courses. Now, before we start, let's answer a few questions you might have in the back of your mind. Can anyone make lots of money online? Yes, even if you have little experience and not a lot of time on your hands. I've scaled multiple online products while holding down a full-time job, actually. Now, this is by no means easy. This will be one of the most difficult things that you've ever done in your life. But if you stick with it, I truly believe that you and anyone else will be able to create a successful digital product and obtain financial freedom. Isn't the digital art market too saturated? Well, no. And while market saturation is definitely a real thing, most of the time this isn't actually the case. And I think a lot of people are looking at the market the wrong way. Let me explain. You and most other people most likely see any given market as a pie, and most slices are already taken up by larger companies, leaving only a tiny slice for you and your great idea. When in reality, the market is much more like a massive, sprawling, endless ocean. Instead of fighting for what's left of the pie, you get to determine the size of the bucket that you bring to the ocean. The better your product, the bigger your bucket is going to be, and the more water, aka income, you are going to be able to generate month to month. Now, it's pretty liberating and exciting when you think about it that way, isn't it? It makes everything seem more manageable. What is passive income and why is it so great? Well, to put it simply, creating a passive income stream is a ton of front-end work and less work in the long run. Once your first income stream is established, you can then set up more and more income streams and not have to worry about things like product overhead, inventory, shipping, and other scary logistics stuff. Once you get the ball rolling, there's really nothing stopping you from running your business from your laptop on a beach like somewhere in the Bahamas. And the last question is, are you committed? This is going to take a lot of work and time. Most people don't fail because they made a bad product. They fail because they gave up. I've seen so many people create an amazing business or product and quit right before they exploded. So do yourself a favor and don't give up. I am not joking when I say anyone can do this. Now, let's talk about creating a product. It's super important to have a clear set of goals established before you even start thinking about what your product's gonna be. These goals may shift over the course of time, but having a solid foundation will really help you keep focused on what is important to you. Always set your goal high. Now, not unrealistically high. I don't think you're gonna make $1 billion a month, but there's nothing stopping you from saying you wanna make, say, $25,000 a month online. It's entirely possible. They're digital sales. Creating an ambitious goal will help shift your mindset, because to sell $25,000 worth of product every month, you'll need to start thinking more creatively and start thinking bigger. Shifting my mindset and telling myself I am capable of pulling numbers like that and that it is doable was an absolute game changer for me. You're never going to hit 10K a month if you set your goal to make just a bit of beer money every month, but you'll probably hit $10,000 a month if you're aiming for $25,000 or even $50,000. These numbers may be scary and massive, but trust me, you can do this. Now, after you've identified your goals, it's time to start thinking about your actual product. The second step in this roadmap is to identify your skill set. Leaning into your already developed skill set will really help you narrow down all of the possibilities that you're probably thinking of. So start thinking about it. Start writing it down. Are you a good public speaker? Are you good at a specific style of art? What kind of software do you enjoy working with? Now, make sure to write down all of these skills, no matter how refined or underdeveloped these skills may be. You'll be needing this list in the next step. Now, here's something extremely important I want you to understand. You're probably thinking, I'm not a master, I'm not a famous artist in the top 1% of my field. Why would anyone ever want to learn or buy from me over all of these other amazing artists? And the answer to this is really simple, and a lot of people tend to overlook this. You don't have to be a master to provide value to someone. You just need to be 1 to 2 steps ahead of your customers, and that's all there is to it. A lot of people out there, including myself, don't necessarily want to learn from a 15-year veteran savant, as a lot of concepts may go over a beginner's head. I'm much more comfortable learning from someone who is maybe 1 to 2 years ahead of me in terms of skill. I found them so much more relatable and easier to listen to, and so do many others out there. I'd way rather follow closely in someone's footsteps instead of watching someone preach from the top of a mountain. I personally have created several successful courses in a few different niches based on just this concept alone. I mean, I really only had 1 year of experience in Substance Painter when I started making tutorials for the coloring book, and yet it has become one of the most successful courses on the planet for that specific software. Sure, I've put a ton of work into it, and it's definitely not perfect, but at the end of the day, I'm still an amateur compared to industry professionals. Yet, here I am, making sales every single day. And if an idiot like me can do it, I think you might be able to as well. So don't stress about not being the best. You're perfectly fine being just okay at something. If you plan ahead, do your research, you can turn those just okay skills into a very solid income stream, which takes us to the most important part of this video, market research. Now, before you even get started working on your idea, it's important to understand your market. And to do that, we need to do some market research. Unfortunately, thinking up a fun idea for a product or course just isn't going to be enough to cut it. You're gonna have to do a ton of research in your niche or field to get a better understanding of the current market. Now, this process can take weeks or even months depending on your area of expertise. The main reason for market research is for you to identify one incredibly crucial thing. What problem are you going to solve? A product is always a response or attempt to solve a problem that resides in any given niche. Think of any product sold by any brand. Now, I want you to think about what problem are they solving and how are they doing it. First, identify your problem you'd like to solve first, and then you can build a viable product around it. You can perform market research in a number of ways. One of the first things I would recommend doing is checking out what other big creators in your field are making. Larger creators often have their finger on the pulse when it comes to recent trends and gaps in the market. Researching creators and their products is a great way to get some insider information that you may not be able to find elsewhere. Now, for digital art, there are also a ton of great online marketplaces where you can conduct research as well. Take a look at some of the highest reviewed courses and products in these marketplaces. Start asking yourself, what is making these products so successful? What can you do to create something that improves on it? Now, here's a small tip that I have found incredibly useful when I'm doing market research. If the product has reviews enabled, filter through them and try to find some of the negative reviews for these bigger products. These negative reviews are incredibly valuable and will give you a ton of insight into where people think the product could be improved. Understanding the niche and the community surrounding it is also incredibly important. Now, I'll cover this more in part 3, but understanding the community surrounding your niche will give you some good insight into how you should create your product. For example, if you know that the vast majority of your niche is young art students, audience in the age range of 18 to 23, then pricing your course or product at $300 a pop might not net you many sales, as most students don't really have access to that amount of funds and are most likely racking up debt from their education. It's sad, but that's just the state of the world right now. Making a reasonably priced product for anywhere between 20 to 50 bucks may be a much better bet. Because even though you're losing about $250 per sale, you could potentially be selling 5 to 6 times more in a day with a more enticing price point. This is coming from personal experience. My coloring book used to be priced at several hundred dollars, and it wasn't until I dropped it to $49.99 that I started to see the sales really skyrocket. At the beginning, I didn't understand the community surrounding my niche. Now, if you're like me and didn't do the proper market research and kept your product at a very high price point, like $300, you could be missing out on potentially thousands of dollars a month. This is why market research is the most important step of the process. Take your time and do not rush it. Don't skip this. Now, I could talk forever about market research, but I want to keep this video relatively short and information dense. So if you really want to dig into how to conduct market research, there are a ton of books on the subject. Pat Flynn of Smart Passive Income also has a great podcast on finding a niche for your online course and how to perform market research. His podcast actually helped me a ton. So I'm going to leave a link to his podcast in the description. Now, I wanted to take a second and give you guys some advice on some of the potential products you could make. I've trialed and errored a ton of these, and I've got a pretty good idea of what works and what doesn't in this niche. So let's talk about some potential products in the digital art space you could make, and if they're a good idea or not, based on just my own personal opinion and experience. It doesn't mean they don't work, it just means I couldn't really make them work. So feel free to try. Now, one of the lowest bars to entry into making money online is selling your models and assets on a digital store like Sketchfab. Would I recommend doing this? No. You need two things to be successful in the model selling game: a large library of models and somewhat decent modeling skills. This is an extremely saturated market, and I only know a handful of people and studios making a considerable living doing this. For the amount of time and effort that this takes, you are much better off pursuing other options. The only time I'd recommend this is if maybe you had a ton of time on your hands. I mean, even then, I still think you're better off trying something else. Having a unique style actually works against you in most cases, because people and studios purchasing these assets want it to match with the style they're working with in their game. But what about prints and merch? Well, if you have a large and dedicated fan base, this is really the only time that this is truly profitable. And then again, if you're a big creator with a dedicated fan base, you're probably already doing this. Okay, what about tools and plugins for specific softwares? Creating tools and plugins can be a nice source of income, but unless you create a game-changing tool and have decent programming experience, you are most likely going to fall flat. However, I have seen people make really creative and useful tools and make a decent living out of it, so don't let me discourage you if you really think that you can make something that will help people. As you may have guessed, selling your own knowledge is probably one of the easiest and most profitable ways to make an income as a digital artist. I found a ton of success making courses, and so have a lot of other creators, not only in the digital art space, but basically in every niche that's ever existed. It honestly feels like everyone and their mother is trying to sell you a course these days, myself included. There is still so much space in the digital art market for more amazing courses and tutorials, and the great thing is that there is always a fresh influx of beginners looking to spend their money on high quality and well-explained tutorials and courses. There is seriously no limit to how much money you can make on courses if you play it right. The demand for knowledge will literally never go away, and all the time you spent learning specific software could really help someone else. Now, I wanted to cover NFTs or non-fungible tokens a bit, but I don't really have much experience in that area yet, and I'd rather not give you guys incorrect or misleading info, so maybe I'll cover them in another video. The one thing I'll say about them is that I've seen a lot of creators have their art blatantly stolen and sold as NFTs, so it's left a bit of a bitter taste in my mouth. Now, I'm all for creators being able to make their own money, but the interest and hype around NFTs seems to be more generated from crypto bros trying to make a quick buck off of artists' work, as opposed to people genuinely thinking NFTs are a viable way to help smaller artists become more independent. But what the hell do I know? Feel free to argue in the comments. While you're doing your market research, you are bound to come across different platforms that people are using to sell their products. I've sold products on most digital platforms, so I wanted to give you guys some insights about selling your product on each one and maybe some of the pros and cons. So what about digital art marketplaces? Honestly, I don't really recommend selling on community digital marketplaces. The only benefit from selling on these marketplaces is that if they have a browse feature, you might get some additional organic traffic from people wandering into your store. However, this traffic is pretty negligible unless you are on top of the trending page. Marketplaces will also often put your own courses and products on sale basically whenever they feel like it, so I'd stay away from them. Having your own product constantly on sale will devalue it, and you can lose a level of control over your own work. However, I've seen a handful of people like JRO Tools, who sells a ton of cool stuff on basically every digital art selling platform, and they seem to be doing very well. You've probably also heard of Gumroad. Gumroad is a really great digital marketplace where a lot of people have tons of success selling their own products. Gumroad accepts PayPal and other payment gateways, and you have full control over how you sell your digital product. They also have a nice little mailing list feature, and I'll talk about more mailing lists in part 3. You can also list your product in their search and browse function, where you can pick up some additional traffic that way. Not only that, you can also integrate Gumroad pretty easily into your own personal website. It's pretty seamless. Gumroad is a really popular selling platform, so people generally feel pretty comfortable purchasing from such a reputable site. And just as a quick aside, if you're interested in selling courses, I would really recommend using a platform called Teachable. I use it for almost all of my courses, and it's been a wonderful experience. Now, after all of your market research is done, it's time to actually build your product. Now, there isn't much I can add here, as there's so many different types of products, and I couldn't hope to even start covering all of them. If you've done your research, you'll have a pretty good idea of what needs to be done. Just remember to ask yourself, would I actually use this product? The answer is no. You don't necessarily have to scrap it, but make the tweaks and changes you need to make until you feel like you're comfortable that you would use it. While you're working on making your product, it's also important to think, how do you make your product stand out from the rest? It is a pretty busy market, and just making a cool brush set and putting it on the ArtStation marketplace isn't enough. What are you going to do to make the purchase absolutely irresistible? Do you get a lot of recommendations by word of mouth? Is it extremely reasonably priced for the amount of content it contains? Is it the only one of its kind and caliber in the market? If you solve this question, you are well on your way to making $10,000 a month online. Another small tip about making your course or product is I want you to think about, how is your product going to elicit an emotional response from someone when they buy it? How do they feel when they're buying it? How is it providing a transformation for the customer? Which I will explain in part 3. In the next video, we're going to cover a topic where most artists fail: building an audience. This is the first real wall you're going to face on your journey. So I'll see you in the next one.